Hi, I'm Tonya Rodriguez. I'm a makeup artist and I specialize in bridal makeup. I started doing makeup when I was in college. I was actually part of a theater group at that time. I was the in-house makeup artist and, you know, during those days, I was so amazed with how makeup can transform and how makeup could give justice to the character. Well, I chose to focus with bridal makeup and weddings and, you know, not into print, TV, or magazines. Because with weddings, for me, it's more heartfelt. And there's a certain sense of fulfillment that I get every time, you know, I see my bride walking down the aisle all made up and I see the groom really appreciating how the bride looks like. All you can do is play to see entirely you deserve. I make it a point to invest with really good products for my clients. I remember when I was a kid, my grandmother would always use Dior skincare on her face. And, you know, it's an expensive brand, but she invests. Why? Because she told me that it's your face. You know, it's the first thing that people notice on you. So why would you let a bad makeup or a bad skincare mess up your face, right? So up to now, that's what I apply with my clients. I buy high-end products. I use mixture of different products from Chanel, Makeup Forever. I use MAC. I use Christian Dior. I use Urban Decay. I use for airbrush, of course. I really like Temptu. It's the best for airbrush. There's no one else. No deceiving. No sense of reason. It's true. Why did you? Basically, I use airbrush for all my brides. Most of my brides, I only use Temptu airbrush for them. Airbrush because airbrush, it lasts longer than the usual regular makeup that we use. It's actually more lightweight on the skin, so it looks more natural. You know, there are different types of bridal makeup. It would depend on my client, but most of my clients would really opt for the clean, natural looking bride. But some of my brides who are based abroad, they would prefer the smoky eyes for their wedding. Some would ask me for that request. I would, of course, agree to them because they're my clients, but I would still make it a point that even if I do them a dark makeup, a smoky eye makeup, I still make it a point that it's not as dark as the usual smoky eyes. I would still make it a point to make it look more on the bridal side. So I use earth tones for them for a smoky eye bride. Another kind of bridal makeup that is one of the trends right now is the vintage bride. It's usually with red lipstick and winged eyes. Usually brides who would opt for this look would have this, they wouldn't opt for the long veil, they would opt for the fascinator type of veil. It's actually timeless, it's actually classic. For the face, I'm using Temptu Airbrush Foundation. It's silicone based. I use this on the bride so that the makeup would last longer on her. It feels lightweight and it's more natural looking. One of the favorite things that I like to do with the face is to contour. Contouring and highlighting the face is very important, especially for a bride. You know, I always like to start with a clean face with my brides. You should always remember to firstly cleanse your face, tone your face if needed, moisturize your face, and of course, proper priming for the face. One trend right now with bridal makeup, they tend to make the eyebrows too thick. I don't like doing my brides with thick eyebrows because it's a trend today. I want my brides to look at their picture 10-20 years from now, but their makeup would still look timeless and classic. So I don't do the eyebrows too thin, nor I don't do it too thick. So for the lipstick, it's the same as with the eye makeup. There's a variety of lipstick that could be used for bridal makeup, so it actually depends on what they want, how they would like to look for their bridal makeup. So usually I use neutral shades of makeup, colors, lipstick colors, browns, corals, pink, is that actually really good. It could actually make you look fresh if you wear pink lipstick. And red lipstick is also good for those that are leaning into the vintage makeup. No sense of reason. Stylist. His style, it would also depend on how the client would want, you know, to look like. What's good with Aries is he listens to what the bride wants. It's not just what he wants for the bride, but he also suggests, like, if this kind of look would look better on you, if this kind of look, you know, would not really complement your face or whatever. But at the same time, you know, he always take into consideration what the client wants, because that's what's most important. So, well, Aries had a trademark hairstyle that he likes to do with most of her brides. It's called the finger comb updo. Why? Because it actually looks good on most facial shapes, with long face, square, round, whatever your facial shape is, it would complement. And one thing that me and Aries likes to advise with the brides is that for the church hair, it would still be best to have your hair updo. First of all, because of the weather in our country, it's hot. So you wouldn't want your hair to be everywhere.
Hi, I'm Aries. I'm Tony's in-house hairstylist. Hair structure is very important during the big day or during wedding. So first, we need to consider if the bride have thin hair or thick hair, if they have small forehead or big forehead. We all need to consider that. We also need to consider what the bride wants during the wedding, if what hairstyle she wants. So we all need to gather all the ideas, and then after that, we always advise our bride to have like a trial hair and makeup session with us at least a month before the big day.
Number one is have your derma appointment, facial appointment, months before your wedding day. Don't get it 3 weeks, 2 weeks, a week, or even the day. That's a disaster, so don't do that. For the wedding day itself, don't condition your hair. Also, for the hair color, have your hair color at least a month or at least 3 weeks before the wedding. So if there will be any reactions to your skin, you know, you wouldn't have to deal with it on the wedding day itself. Thank you, and please check my website at www.tonyrodriguezmakeup.com.